The Apple ecosystem is well-renowned for its tight integration into its apps and its services that people use. One of the most common ones, of course, is Photos. Why? Because you take a lot of photos on your phone and they just get stored into your Photos app. Well, when you want to go and edit those suckers, and maybe you don't want to use Final Cut Pro or iMovie because you just like DaVinci Resolve, turns out, even with DaVinci Resolve, which would technically be considered a third-party app, you can still use your Photos app with that tight Apple integration. And I'm going to show you today in DaVinci Resolve over 40, in 30, day 29, I'm going to show you how to use things out of your Photos app. This is going to be light, quick, but it comes in handy because I was talking with Gretchen today. I know she's sort of heavily integrated into her Photos app. So am I. And I'm like, well, what happens if I'm on a plane and I want to throw together a tight slideshow or a tight video or just a quick wrap up to share on social media? I got this long flight. Like, what can I do on the flight when I'm bored? Turns out I got good Wi-Fi on mine. I don't know about you. We got Starlink. So I can show you how to jump in and get these done on DaVinci Resolve. Let me show you the iPad first, and then I'll show you how to do it on your computer. Okay? Bingo, bango, pickly mango. All right, here we go. So we're in DaVinci Resolve. We're going to come down here, bust out a new project, and we'll just call this Photos. That's not how you spell show. Man, I can't see sideways. It's kind of funny. Okay, so we're going to press that, and we're done. You're going to click on Import Media, and you see this right here. This is just going to take you to things on your iPad. That's not going to give you what you want, and this had me absolutely perplexed for a hot minute, right? Scroll down here and look at all these things, and nothing was sort of like I wanted it to be, and I couldn't figure out why. I was like, man, that doesn't make any sense. All right, so let me show you what the real deal Holyfield is. You're going to click on in the very top up here. There's a little icon, and you're going to press and hold. And it's hard to do with the pencil. But if you press and hold, you're going to see it says, let me not hit anything. It says import from photos right there. So you hit that, bingo, and then it should load the items. There we go. I'm going to hit collections because I have some collections already saved. And I have an album here. Let me get you more in focus. I have an album here called Creator Camp. Right. So if I click on that album, this is going to bring up photos and images and pictures that we use during our annual Creator Camp festivities in Massachusetts. So if I wanted to bring in these, I'm not going to grab too many. Just keep it kind of simple. I just wanted you to see what we're doing here. Select those, hit the checkbox. Now, this is a little bit irritating to me. There is no sort of indication that anything is happening. But what you need to know about photos is that if it's been a while since you touched that footage, like, you know, these are from earlier in the year, it's going to take a while for them suckers to download and eventually populate, but they will. And there you go. Now they're over here and they're populated. I can drag this guy down and you can sort of see what we sort of dragged in. The other thing that I wish, this is probably more Apple. If I press and hold that again and go to import from photos, I do want to show you that if I'm on collections, I'm here on Creator Camp, you can squeeze this down to get a better idea of what you're working with, or you can come up bigger. What it doesn't really do, which I wish it did, I mean, a little indicator maybe, it doesn't show you if it's landscape or portrait. You just kind of sort of need to kind of know that. And if I wanted to grab this guy right there, that's a really short one. But yeah. It just doesn't really do a good job of letting you know what's landscape and what's portrait, and I kind of wish it did. But if I press that and say, okay, that one's quick because those files are short. All right, and then once you do that, you can do the rest, create your timeline, throw things on the timeline. So if I just wanted to grab this really short clip and drag it onto the timeline, boom, there it is, right? And of course, I can go to the inspector, and since this guy is really slow, I mean, really short, I'll hit speed change and maybe come over to the center and then hit a freeze frame. And then now I got a longer clip that I can mess with, right? Because we just sort of freeze it out. Anyway, we won't get into editing with the iPad just yet. Just wanted to let you know that that is a possibility. And with those small little, you know, things there, it's doable, but just, listen, people, you have to give people indicators. If you're a UI designer, And you got people, you especially muggles, you got to give indicators. Like, I know that iCloud has to download it. Average user might not necessarily know that. You're making people's life hard. Okay? Are you listening? All right, cool. Let me stop tripping. Now, let's do the desktop version. Here we are in DaVinci Resolve. First thing I'm going to do is drop down here to the cut page. And I'm going to right-click in this empty spot and create a new bend. And then up here where you can't see it, let me zoom it in a little bit. Where's my mouse? I'm going to type on the name of this bend and do Photos app. Bingo, right? Come back down. If we double click on this new bend and then right click and go down to where it says import media, that is command I as well. You can use either or. I'm going to hit import media, and this is confusing. Okay, I don't know why, but it just is. Not even if you click here will it do much. You have to go all the way under the sidebar, scroll way down. Let me not be zoomed in so much. Hold on. That's a little obnoxious. Here we go. Scroll all the way down to under media, and you'll see photos. You click on photos, and then you're going to go in. And again, it doesn't really give you a good job of allowing you to select albums and things like that. This they need to fix, but I'll just bring in some other stuff that I had thought about and I kind of already pre-downloaded, so this should be quick. Where does it go? Here we go. So I'm going to select this photo and hold down the shift key, this one, and this one, right? And I'll go ahead and say open, and those guys will be downloaded, and you'll see the little spirally guy. The little spirally guy right there is letting you know that it's downloading. And then once it's finished downloading those, it'll end up back in your bin. And of course, from there, you can go ahead and edit it. So let's let that sucker work. And we'll be back in a few moments later. So you can see that now these guys are here. And all I need to do is just drop it on the timeline, you know, and I can go to town and get to editing. You know, slip another clip in the front, so forth, so on, et cetera. You know the drill by now. With those simple steps, you can easily get access to your photos and videos that you have in your photos album on your Apple devices, Apple's photos. We used to say iPhotos, no matter what you call it. If you find yourself wanting to put together a holiday slideshow, something for granddad, like in that one Apple commercial, or something just to share memories, clips, highlight reels, whatever, you can easily do it with DaVinci Resolve and the Apple Photos ecosystem. Now, you know what I say around here? I don't know who need to hear this. Well, except Gretchen and me. But if it was you, let me know in the comment section below. This has been DaVinci Resolve over 40 in 30, day 29. If you like this video, press the like button, press the subscribe button, ring the notification bell so you never miss another one of these videos. And right about now, the algorithm is going to show you another video they think you should watch, and I agree with them.
I need to know everything, who in the what and the where, I need everything. Trust me, I hear what you're saying, but I like it's new what you're telling me. I'm curious, George, I hop in the Porsche, a five and a horse, I'm ready for war, I'm coming for throats, to turn to a ghost, I need to know everything. Now you'll be surprised at the info you get is by letting them talk, so I'm letting them talk. Gotta keep quiet, maneuver in silence, then let them in talk.